So someone made Mother Nature very unhappy this recent year, because every time we turn around, there seems to be another natural disaster happening, and therefore someone's getting at least an extension or some sort of break on their tax return. Lisa Greene-Lewis, TurboTax expert and CPA, is here with us right now. I mean, there are a lot of federally declared disasters this year, aren't there?
Yes, there have been everything from fires to floods, storms. So yes, there are, and there are things that people should know, you know, as far as saving money and getting relief on filing their taxes.
So where's the first place you should go? Like, if I believe that I would guess people know whether they're in a federally declared disaster zone, but if they don't, where's the first place they should go to at least get that information?
The IRS, they do have a disaster relief page that you can go to. And then also on the TurboTax blog, we're constantly updating information as that type of relief comes in. So you can head there as well.
So once I figure out that I'm in a federally disaster declared zone, what are some of the things I need to know about? I mean, casualty losses abound when you're part of a disaster.
Yeah, the first thing you need to know, the IRS, they typically issue relief. So that can be relief in the form of giving you extra time to pay if you owe taxes and also file your taxes. So we saw a lot of that this year with all of the storms. There was relief in various different dates where people were able to extend without filing a tax extension. So some of those dates, you should look at your specific state, but a lot of them were extending the tax year 2022 deadline to July, some in September and some in October.
Yeah, I think that's the important thing. Figure out your deadlines most importantly, right? Some people sadly might not even have documents left. So that's a whole nother can of worms. But the whole casualty loss issue, do I take it this year? Do I take it next year? What do I need to know about that?
Yeah, so a lot of people don't realize that there is a possibility. So let's say, for example, a disaster unfortunately happens in this year, 2023, but we're not filing our taxes yet for 2023. You can amend your tax year 2022 taxes and claim that casualty loss on there. So that's one thing that a lot of people are unaware of. Or if you want, you can just wait until we're filing tax year 2023 taxes.
Right, so I guess it depends on how quickly you need the money and if you want to go back and amend and you have that capability. Look, I think the big takeaway here is if you are in a federally declared area, you should go either onto the IRS's site or TurboTax site, figure out the benefit you get from it, and take advantage of it, because it certainly was a hardship. Lisa Greene-Lewis, TurboTax expert and CPA, thank you for sharing that.
Thank you for having me.